Hey friends, I'm so glad you're here this morning. I hope you're doing well. And just like we normally do in large group, Miss Paige wants to give you two quick announcements. One is I've started a project called Send a Card. You know, a lot of our senior adults are at home and they don't get to see many of their friends and family right now. And so a card can do a lot to cheer them up. So I want to encourage you to make a card or two or even three, and I want you to decorate them and just tell them you're thinking about them. Draw a pretty picture, and then you can leave them in the church mailbox every day between 12 and 4, and Miss Paige will pick those up and she'll get them to Miss Wendy so that those can get mailed out. The other thing that I want to let you know, because I know the boys will be very interested in this, is our RA Derby race. Y'all turned in your cars this past week and they look great. So Mr. Andy and Mr. Christopher, this year we're going to be doing a virtual derby race. So I just wanted to let you know they are hoping to have that ready for you to watch on Saturday, May the 9th. So stay tuned and Miss Paige will make sure that Mom and Dad know about what's coming up so you don't miss it. All right, so let's jump into our lesson this morning. You know, we've been working our way through the Old Testament this year, and we've been in the book of Daniel. And today is going to be our last lesson on Daniel before we move on to the next book. Now, last week, do you remember what we learned? We talked about Daniel being thrown into a lion's den just because he prayed to God. Wow. Now, last week I challenged you with some questions to talk to Mom and Dad about on prayer, and I hope you took some time this week to not only talk to God in prayer, but to talk to Mom and Dad about what prayer is and why it's so important. Now, also I want you to remember, as we get ready to go into our lesson, that a few weeks ago, we talked about a really strange dream that King Nebuchadnezzar had. Well, today, we're going to be learning about another dream. But not that Nebuchadnezzar had, but that Daniel himself had. So I have a question for you. Have you ever had a really crazy dream? You know, one you just kind of wake up and you're scratching your head and going, what does that mean? Well, Miss Paige is going to tell you a little secret. I'm almost embarrassed to admit it. I've had a crazy dream. And it was about an elephant and a pink tutu. Now, where did that come from? And what did it mean? I'm going to have to think about that. It probably meant Miss Paige had too much chocolate before bed. But that's not what Daniel dreamed. You know, we don't always even remember the dreams that we have. And not every dream has a meaning. Certainly not my elephant in the pink tutu. But Daniel's dream had a very important meaning. Now, also, God told Daniel what this dream meant. And that is going to be so important. And we're going to talk about that at the end of the lesson. So I can't wait for you to hear about this lesson because a lot of us may not have heard it. I know Miss Paige hasn't read it that often over the years. And so it was a good reminder for me. So I hope you will enjoy it. But before we get going, I want to give you just a little background information, okay? So today's lesson is going to come from Daniel chapter 7. And this is actually one of the most important chapters in the Old Testament. The chapter and the chapters that are coming after it describe these visions and prophecies that were given about God's people, to the people, from God about their future. And it gave hope to them. Remember, they've been in captivity and they need some hope. They're discouraged, they're frustrated. And so God used these things to shed light and to shed hope. Well, today's Bible lesson takes place during the reign of King Belshazzar. Now, Belshazzar was the son of King Nebuchadnezzar. How's that for a mouthful? And so we met Belshazzar in chapter 5. Now, remember, when we talked about Daniel in the lion's den, Daniel was about 82 years old when he was thrown into the lion's den. Well, chapter 7 is going to hit the rewind button, and we're going to go backwards to learn about this dream when Daniel had when he was about 67 years old. And it was such a strange dream. I've never heard anything like it. So in this dream, Daniel saw a big windstorm. And out of that windstorm, four big creatures came up from the sea. And every creature was different. Listen. The first creature was like a lion, but it had wings like an eagle. The second creature was like a bear, and it had three ribs in its mouth. The third creature was like a leopard, but it had four wings and four heads. And then the fourth creature, He was strong and scary, and it had large teeth made of iron, and he destroyed everything in its path. And it also had 10 horns. Isn't that just the craziest thing? But that's not the end of the dream. Then Daniel saw a heaven with thrones, and God sat on the throne to judge the creatures. And his clothing and his hair was white just like snow, and his throne was like fire. Well, Daniel saw God take away the creature's power. Now, God allowed those first three creatures to live for a little while, but the fourth creature was killed. And then, all of a sudden, he saw the Son of Man come, and God gave him the power to rule over everything. He was the king, and people from every nation and every language were serving him. His kingdom would last forever, and it was never going to be destroyed. So just who is the Son of Man? Do you know? Tell Mom and Dad if you do. Well, the Son of Man is Jesus. Wow, talk about an interesting dream, but super confusing too, right? Well, let me tell you one last interesting thing. Daniel didn't tell anybody about this dream. The Bible says he kept it in his heart. I think I might have too. But thankfully, Daniel did write it down so that we could read about it and learn about it. So how would you feel if you'd had a dream like Daniel's? Well, the Bible tells us that Daniel was terrified and confused. But I love what he did. He asked for help understanding. He wanted to know what the dream meant. And God answered him by giving him that understanding, by telling him what the dream meant. And the meaning of this dream was very important then, and it's really actually very important for us today. So the four creatures were earthly kingdoms. It was the kingdom of Babylon, the kingdom of the Medes and Persians, Greece and Rome. And all four of these kingdoms were world powers at some point or other in history. But their rule is not going to last forever because God has power over each of them. Why? Because remember, we've talked about this, because he is the King of Kings. God may allow people or rulers to rule for a short time, but you're going to see, just like in your lifetime, you're going to see different rulers and people in charge, people with authority, and they may rule for a short time, but the Bible is clear that God has always existed and his power lasts forever. The book of Revelation tells us that God is the one who is, who was, and is to come. He's the Almighty. And so he's going to come and he's going to judge the nations. But the great thing about God is that he is a fair judge. He is a good judge. And you know, we've talked about this before, and it reminded me of one of our old Got Truth verses. We need to remember that God looks at the heart, and he's going to judge the heart. And he looks at the heart of us, and he looks at the heart of leaders. And when he sees us, we're guilty. You know, all people start out dead in sin, according to the Bible. And the Bible tells us that the punishment for that sin is death. But thankfully, Jesus took that punishment for us when he died on the cross so that we could have eternal life with God. And someday, everybody, me and you, we're all going to stand before God and we're going to face judgment. But all of us who have trusted in Jesus are going to get to live forever with him. And the beautiful thing is that when we stand before God, he's not going to see our sin. If we've trusted in him, instead, he's going to see the righteousness of Jesus. What a beautiful picture, guys. And God used this dream to show Daniel that very thing, that he is the King of Kings, that he rules over everything, and that one day he's going to come back and he's going to set up his earthly kingdom, and it's going to be perfect and wonderful. And you see, this gave hope to the people in captivity that things weren't always going to be the way that they were. And boys and girls, it should give you hope. I know sometimes we talk about how y'all have seen bad things or sinful things or things that are hard that you don't understand. And this dream could give you hope that God's going to come back. He's going to rule. He's going to make things right. And you know, he's going to get rid of all evil. He promises us that. And he's always faithful. So who knew that we could get such a wonderful reminder out of such a crazy, confusing dream? But we do. It gives us such a hope that we can look forward to the day that Jesus is going to come back. Now, I want to pray, and then after we pray, I want to go over our Got Truth verse, because Got Truth Sunday will be here before we know it. So let's pray, and then we're going to jump into that, okay? Dear God, thank you so much for today. I thank you for each of my elementary friends and their families who are watching. God, I pray that you will continue to watch over them, keep them safe, keep them well. God, I thank you for each one of them. And Lord, I just thank you for your promise of hope, or your promise that you will return. And Lord, that you have offered us salvation, and that if we trust in you, we get to live with you forever. Lord, I pray that you'll make yourself very real to all of my elementary friends, Lord, that they will learn to more about you and learn to trust in you more. God, we love you, and we thank you for today. In Christ's name, amen. All right, Got Truth Sunday will be here in one more week. So we have a verse that we set out to learn really for Easter, and it's from Zechariah 9:9. And I want you to say it with me, okay? Behold, your king is coming, righteous and having salvation is he, humble and mounted on a donkey. Zechariah 9:9. All right, you still have time to learn this verse. You still have time to post a video, send me a text. Let me see those verses. Some of you have already sent them to me, and I'm so proud of you. You've done a great job. Now, you also may be wondering, have you missed any verses? If you're worried about that, email me, let me know, and I'll send you the ones you need to work on so that you can still get your Got Truth shirt, okay? All right, guys, I hope you have a great week. I sure miss you, and I love you, and I can't wait to see you. Bye.
Hey there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kids. Landon from Columbus, Georgia asks,
sometimes the things I read in the Bible are kind of scary or don't make sense. Is it okay to ignore the parts of the Bible I don't like?
Landon, that is a great question. And let me just say from the start, very clearly, there are things in the Bible that are scary. There are things in the Bible that are confusing. There are things in the Bible that are difficult. There are things in the Bible that I don't necessarily like. I kind of wish they weren't there. That is true for all of us. So it's not just a matter of you being a kid trying to understand some things. Even we as adults, we have a hard time. But here's the reality. We need to spend time even in the hard things, even the scary things in the Bible. You know, this week's story is a perfect example of that, where we see this vision, and it's a confusing vision. It's of four creatures. They're kind of animals, they're not. What does it mean? We try to imagine what these animals, these creatures would look like, and it's kind of scary. And so it's very tempting just to kind of move on and find a Bible story that is easier, that is clearer, that is happier, that is less confusing. But the problem if we do that is this. The Bible is one big story of God's plan to redeem people through Jesus Christ. Every single little story we study is part of that bigger story. And you know this because this is what the Gospel Project is all about. This is what we try to show you every single week. And if we started skipping the stories that we don't like, the ones that are confusing or scary, then we miss parts of the story. Let me give you the perfect example. I would say that the scariest thing, the hardest thing in all the Bible is this. God's judgment of sin. You think about it, God judging sin, that we are separated from Him forever because of sin, is the scariest thing that we can encounter in Scripture. But if we skip that, we miss the beauty of the gospel, because if we don't understand why we need to be saved, then salvation isn't really impressive. So we've got to spend some time understanding sin, understanding God's justice and judgment because of sin, because when we do, we understand grace. We understand mercy, we understand the love of God that much more beautifully. So I want to encourage you, spend time in those hard parts. Work through them. Are they challenging? Yes, but it's worth it. And keep in mind, you're not going to understand everything in this book. I don't either. None of us will, because our minds can't grasp the infinite God. But it's worth trying. It's worth taking the time, working through. And, you know, you have friends there, you have teachers, you have parents that you can go to and say, hey, help me understand this. And you can explore these beautiful truths in the Bible, even those hard ones, together. So here's a question back for you. What are some teachings in the Bible that you have a hard time understanding or believing?